Deep Dive with David Stendahl, where we trade without ego, no emotion, no greed, and no opinion. Before we begin tonight's video blog, please read over our trading disclaimer and remember to trade smart and accept the reality that trading futures is risky. This presentation does not provide buy-sell recommendations, and our information is strictly provided for educational purposes only. As always, trade at your own risk and analysis. Hey there, it's David Snow with tonight's Deep Dive. It is May 30th, 2019. Thought I'd take a look at copper, the ETF being CPER. The reason I'm looking at that is I'm going to highlight some of the things that I don't normally look at, just kind of a general trend to the market with the short, intermediate, and long-term trends all pointing to the downside. The technicals pointing to the downside, the seasonals pointing to the downside, and whenever you get that kind of a condition, it just simply means a continuation of the same old, in this case, to the downside. And so there's always opportunities during these types of trends, and I just want to show you as to how long this can this take place and what you can actually take advantage of. The other thing is that when we look at the deep dive alerts, here's copper down at the bottom. If there's nothing showing up, it just simply means that there's no basing, there's no any indication that's telling us that the market is not going to continue to the downside. So that trend should continue. Once we start seeing things pop up here, well, then we would expect potentially some type of a pop to the market. For right now, we're not seeing any of those things, and we're obviously taking advantage of that with our systems. So here's the seasonals. You can see that copper is not the high end, but it's at least on that list, you know, with the fact that it's seasonally accurate. And so anytime you see the seasonal top 10, any market that's on here, that's something you probably want to take a look at. If we take a look at the actual seasonal tendencies, this the 10 years, you can see that it's seasonally accurate with this little grayish area highlighting the fact that it's seasonally accurate. The black line represents this year's action. The blue line represents the general seasonal tendencies. So what we have here is sort of a peak in early April with a downtrend into June, call it the third weekish of June, and that's when we start to see the next phase to the market. So this trend that we're talking about is probably going to continue for a little while longer. Obviously, it'll be bouncy and, you know, jump around a little bit, but the general trend should still be to the downside. But we're at the tail end of the trend as opposed to the beginning of the trend. So keep that in mind when we actually look at things. With where we are with our systems, we are, here's copper right here, we're short copper, net short, and we got a nice little open position profit with net, just one position, one system, with all of the netting going on, but just simply short one particular system in this case. You can see in gold we're doing pretty well. We've got two systems that are long, call it $2,000 profit, $7,100 here in copper, and we've got three systems that are short net-net, and we've got a nice open position right through there. So you can tell that with the profitability of the trades, since we do this on a contract basis, not everything, you know, and doing, you know, things from that side, but on a contract basis, you know, net unit contract basis, up, you know, $7,100, that's not too shabby. And so from that standpoint, it tells you that the trend has been underway for a little bit. So if we actually take a look at copper, here's that trend to the downside. These are daily bars that we're seeing right through here. And what we're looking for is a target. Where is the next logical spot where the market's headed? And are we there yet? The answer is right now, no, we are not. So here we are at 65.40. And if we take a look at these two thresholds over here, we have one at 61.58 right through here, and the stronger of the two is 60.57 right through here. So what we're expecting is for the market to sell perhaps a little bit further before it hits that major support to the market. Then obviously we'll review again and see as whether or not it's going to break and then come down to this much lower level. But for right now, the key levels that you should be looking at are 61.58 and 60.57. That's what these two levels are right through there. If we actually flip back to the website and look at targets, you can see that there's a gap upcoming. So if some of those levels don't hold, you know, in the 62.0, the 60.60 or 66 level right through here, if we don't hold, there's a pretty good size gap. So that's why I'm a little excited for copper, is that yes, it should go down a little bit further. That trend should continue. That's what we're actually looking at. But if we don't hold here at some of these thresholds, then there's a support gap, a gap between this level of support and this lower level of support with nothing really in between it. And if that's the case, then it should be able to break through that fairly easily if it's so inclined. So there's a little more downside potential, and something that we're obviously looking at to take advantage of this short position that's been underway for a little bit here. Now, the other thing I want to point out is that with copper in particular, and there's other markets are doing the same thing, but the trends to the downside, the technicals and the seasonals to the downside, that's always a critical thing that we're always looking for within the indicators themselves, and it's something that we highlight in our deep dive cheat sheet. So if you wanted to download this little cheat sheet, it kind of goes through some of the indicators, what to look for and what's powerful, what is something that is not as powerful but something you still want to be looking at. And what we're looking at now is a trend, obviously in copper, and a fairly substantial one. And so when you get those types of conditions, that's something that's important. So the way to get this little cheat sheet where we highlight these things, if you come to Signals, Deep Dive Analysis, and then come down to the Deep Dive Cheat Sheet, you can come to this, fill out the information. If you're already a customer, if you're a potential customer, it's okay. You can fill out the information and click download it, and then get a better feel for what we're talking about with some of these types of indicators, just to sort of round out your education as to what we're looking at, and give you an idea as to what's important and what's not as important. Because there's a lot that is actually going on, with tight support resistance levels. How does that then relate to some of these other things that are on the page when we're looking at gold? And so there's just a fair amount of information that can be had with this synopsis of what the markets are doing, and this little cheat sheet will go a long ways to sort of telling you which ones you should be looking at and what's important and what is not as important. So that's the kind of the point right here. So with the systems being short the market, we've got a fair amount of open position profit, a little bit of flexibility here, but with the seasonal tendencies and that support level that I'm talking about, we're looking for a little more downside potential, at least on a low basis, maybe not a closing, but a low basis, and we'll see us whether or not we're able to break some of those support levels and get this market rolling in the right direction. Some of the other markets have done extraordinarily well. So again, coming back to this particular sheet, there are plenty of markets that we could be looking at that have shown a lot of strength as of late, and looking for opportunities to short or reverse, and hopefully we'll be able to look at those perhaps over the course of the weekend. So with that, thanks very much for watching, and we'll look at another market soon. Bye-bye.